Cappella Gadanensis has just performed Requiem by Giacomo Puccini.
W imię Ojca i Syna i Ducha Świętego.
Introductory rites.
Pan z wami. Przyszliśmy tutaj.
We have come here.
Z niedowierzaniem.
With disbelief.
Że to nasze ostatnie ziemskie spotkanie
our final earthly
ze świętej pamięci
with the late
Jerzym Limonem.
Jerzy Limon.
Justyno,
Justyna,
Januszu,
Janusz,
Julio, Tomaszu, wszyscy Julia, najbliżsi
Tomasz,
wam chcemy dać znak
to you that we want to
naszej
give
solidarności. Naszej przyjaźni, naszej
our
pamięci.
Friendship, our memory.
Witam wszystkich, którzy dzisiaj tu
I welcome everyone
przyszliście.
Who has come here today.
Przyjaciele,
friends,
ludzie teatru.
People associated with theater.
Międzynarodowy Dzień Teatru.
On the International
taki
Theater Day.
Zostawia nam
this is the sign
los.
That we are left with
żegnamy
by fate,
wielkiego
that we are saying farewell to
tak
a great personality
ważnym,
of theater in, on such a, an important symbolic day.
Pewnie byłyby tu tłumy,
perhaps
gdyby
crowds
nie
would attend
pandemia.
If it were not for the pandemic.
Pewnie jest nas wielu również w domach
perhaps
przed
there
ekranami.
Are many of us in our homes, in front
chcemy
of our screens, and this is how
powiedzieć Jerzemu
we want to
do zobaczenia.
Say farewell to Jerzy and see you again.
Wydaje się, że przychodzimy jakby na
it seems as if
premierę,
we were coming
na nowy spektakl.
To a first night of a new play.
Jakbyśmy
as
chcieli
if
przekonać się, co Jerzy
we wanted to
chce nam
find
powiedzieć
out
w swoim teatrze życia.
What Jerzy wanted to tell us in his life's theater.
Przychodzimy patrząc
we come
na
here
jego zdjęcie, na jego
looking at his
twarz uśmiechniętą, na to oblicze
at his
pełne
face,
marzeń, pogodne i wizjonerskie.
So full of dreams, so cheerful, so visionary.
Aż trudno nam uwierzyć, że to jest
and it is difficult to
ostatnia droga,
that this is his last
że to jest odprowadzenie
journey,
na miejsce doczesnego spoczynku.
His being taken to his
jesteśmy
place, final place of rest.
Trudną sytuacją wokół nas.
Dejected
i tym doświadczeniem
with the difficult situation
Jerzego
around us and with the experience
ale
of loss of Jerzy's departure.
Między rozpaczą
but between this
a nadzieją
despair and hope,
wybrać nadzieję.
We want to choose hope.
Myślę, że Jerzy
and I think that Jerzy
gdyby miał możliwość
if he had the opportunity
zaaranżowania, wyreżyserowania swojego pożegnania
his own farewell,
zrobiłby to pewnie w sposób
he
teatralny
would probably do it in
może
a theatrical manner,
ornacie.
Perhaps like
on
my liturgical clothes,
taniec
a dance
śmierci,
of death,
który jest próbą oswojenia tego
a dance of death that is an attempt to make this very dramatic experience more familiar,
życia.
The experience of
taniec,
the end of life, a dance that is an expression of vitality,
zderzony
and it clashes with soulless
kostuchą
and dead Grim Reaper.
Trochę próba dystansu, próba
it's a way of distancing oneself, maybe trying to be ironic a little
jesteśmy
bit.
Na progu
we are at a threshold
takiego doświadczenia, w którym
of such an experience
można doznać
where
albo załamania,
we can be we can either break down
nowe
or
świata, nowy
quite the opposite,
wzrok,
gain a new perception of the world,
świat,
a new way
odchodzi
of seeing the world
nadzieję,
that is departing.
Smutną
well, let's hope that it's
pandemiczną
going to leave us with this whole sad pandemic situation as well. But
i w pamięci przy ołtarzu jest
we
z nami
are
dzisiaj ksiądz
continuing
Wojciech,
here.
Przez wiele lat był
Reverend Wojciech is here with us. He
Justyny
has
Jerzego
been a parish priest of Justyna
jest
and Jerzy for many
tylu
years.
Którzy
there
chcemy
are so many of us
całą swoją myśl
who
i
want to give all our thoughts and kind wishes
dzisiaj przed obliczem najwyższego Boga,
to
Jerzy
the Almighty,
już
where Jerzy is already standing and perhaps he's already discussing the life that he has completed. Let us now ask the Lord for our forgiveness for our sins and ask him to renew his image in us. Kapella Gedanensis is performing Franz Schubert.
Panie Jezu, który przez śmierć na krzyżu zgładziłeś nasze grzechy, zmiłuj się nad nami. Zmiłuj się nad nami. Chryste, który przez Twoje zmartwychwstanie przywróciłeś nam życie wieczne, zmiłuj się nad nami. Zmiłuj się nad nami. Panie, który przez Twoje wejście do chwały otworzyłeś nam drogę do nieba, zmiłuj się nad nami. Zmiłuj się nad nami.
Módlmy się.
Let us pray.
Boże Ojcze Wszechmogący,
O God, Almighty Father,
wierzymy, że Twój Syn umarł
faith professes
i zmartwychwstał.
That your Son died and rose
Spraw
again.
Łaskawie,
mercifully grant
aby mocą tej tajemnicy,
that through this mystery
Jerzy,
your servant Jerzy,
który zasnął
who has fallen asleep in Christ,
przez niego may rejoice to rise again through him. Prosimy Cię o to przez naszego
through
Pana
Lord,
Jezusa
Jesus
Chrystusa,
Christ,
Twojego
Son,
Syna, który z Tobą żyje i króluje w jedności Ducha Świętego,
Spirit,
Bóg przez wszystkie wieki
forever
wieków.
And ever.
Spocznijmy teraz i posłuchajmy słów
Let us now sit
Pisma
down
Świętego,
and
które
listen to
wybraliśmy
the words
na uroczystość
from the Bible, which we have selected
żałobną. Będzie to i mądrość Starego Przymierza i
It'll
wizja Apokalipsy
of the old covenant
i Ewangelia
and the
o tych, którzy zwątpili, a potem odzyskali nadzieję. Posłuchajmy.
Regain their hope. Let us listen.
Czytanie z Księgi
A reading
Mądrości.
From the Book of Wisdom.
Dusze sprawiedliwych
The souls of the righteous
są w ręku Boga
are in the hand of God
i nie dosięgnie ich
and there męka. Shall no torment touch them.
Zdało się oczom głupi,
in the sight
pomarli,
of the unwise, they seemed to die, and their departure is taken for misery,
I odejście
and
od
their
nas
going from us
za unicestwienie
to be utter destruction.
A oni
but they
trwają
are in peace.
W pokoju. Choć nawet w ludzkim rozumieniu
For though
doznali
they be
kazni,
punished in the sight of men,
nadzieja ich pełna
yet
jest
is their hope full of immortality.
Po nieznacznym skarceniu
And having been a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded.
Bóg ich bowiem
For God proved them
I znalazł ich
and found them worthy for himself.
Siebie.
Doświadczył ich As gold in the furnace hath he tried them
I przyjął ich
and received them as a burnt offering.
Jak całopalną ofiarę. Ci, którzy mu zaufali,
they that put their trust in him
zrozumieją
shall understand
prawdę.
The truth.
Wierni w miłości
and such as be faithful in love
będą przy nim trwali.
Shall abide with him.
Łaska bowiem
for grace
I miłosierdzie
and mercy
dla jego wybranych.
Is to his saints.
Oto słowo Boże.
And he hath care for his elect, the word of the Lord. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Yea, our God is merciful. The Lord preserveth the simple. I was brought low, and he helped me. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I believed, therefore I have spoken. I was greatly afflicted. I said in my haste, all men are liars. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. O Lord, truly I am thy servant. I am thy servant and the son of thine handmaid. Thou hast loosened my bonds. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living.
A reading from the book of Revelation. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Chwała Tobie, Słowo Boże.
Glory be the word of God. For so God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
po śmierci Jezusa.
And behold, two of them went that same day to a village called Emmaus, which was from Jerusalem about 60 furlongs. And they talked together of all these things which had happened. And it came to pass that while they communed together and reasoned, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. But their eyes were holden that they should not know him. And they drew nigh unto the village whither they went, and he made as though he would have gone thither. But they constrained him, saying, Abide with us, for it is toward evening, and the day is far spent. And he went in to tarry with them. And it came to pass, as he sat at meat with them, he took bread and blessed it, and brake and gave to them. And their eyes were opened, and they knew him. And he vanished out of their sight. And they said to one to another, Did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way, and while he opened to us the scriptures? And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem, and found the 11 gathered together, and them that were with them, saying, The Lord is risen indeed, and hath appeared to Simon. And they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread.
Oto słowo Pańskie.
The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us sit down.
Po tych słowach,
after these words from the Bible, there's time for reflection
serca, z głębi
and
przyjaźni,
for some words from deep in our friendship, in our hearts,
moi drodzy, jesteśmy trochę
words
jak ci uczniowie.
Of hope. We are like those disciples who go to Emmaus and who are touched by the death of their master. They felt resigned from the adventure they began 3 years before, and they walked back bitter and disillusioned, perhaps to their fishing nets, to their farms, to their everyday ordinary life. But their hopes had been kindled. They went on the road for a great adventure with the Master of Nazareth. And therefore, we hear their words of discouragement, of disillusionment, and but we had hoped, and this hope was burst when death came. There was no revolution, there was no toppling of the Romans, there was no creation of a new Israel. All their hopes were gone, and they went home on their. And suddenly there's something strange happened where they meet a passerby who tries to explain something to them. Why are you sad, he asks. Why do you argue about things which are in the past? Try to see the future. And they, step by step, started to understand and feel something. First, intuitively, they just ask him to stay with them because they feel something, that he can explain the situation, that there might be a breakthrough. And indeed, they recognize him when he breaks the bread, when he gives them food. And they know that it's not just an ordinary bread, that it's the same gesture that happened at the Last Supper. that it is the gesture of the Savior. And you hear the report later. They run to Jerusalem, to their dreams, to their great plans. With hope, they begin to see anew. And before, their eyes were holden, as we heard. And through an analogy, I try to see our situation today. Our situation where we are tired, the theaters are closed, we are in isolation. So many of our friends who have been sick in the pandemic, and so many of our friends who are gone. And now Jerzy, suddenly, in a situation where no one could have foreseen, with all his visions and plans, looking always toward the future, in just a few days is gone. And we might say that, oh, we expected something. But after all, Jerzy leaves his testament with us. I had a chance to read an unpublished book by Jerzy, which is practically ready to print, and he left it right before he went to hospital. Seven Deadly Sins in Shakespeare. In the introduction to the book, from the words and the letters, he showed himself to be a great erudite, as a man who not only knew Shakespeare inside out, because he was one of the most outstanding experts on Shakespeare in the world. He devoted his entire life to research all the mysteries which Shakespeare, the genius, left us in his plays and poems. Jerzy was also deeply rooted in the entire European Judeo-Christian tradition. And in this introduction, he writes about the sins, which are the beginning of any play. There is no play without a sin. Also, the Bible, Jerzy wrote, begins with a sin. Adam and Eve, the first humans, sin with pride. Cain kills his brother. These are the first pages of the book of Genesis. And he quotes not only the Bible, but also the first Christian mysticist, Agarius of Pontus, who categorized the eight bad thoughts. But he was the first to attempt to name the human weaknesses, which we now call the seven deadly sins. And among them is sloth. And Jerzy smiles from his text and saying that it would be very difficult to begin a drama play with sloth because it's boring. It's hard to get a plot from that. And I think that we could think anything about Jerzy, even his weaknesses. Well, you could certainly not attribute sloth to him. Every one of us has got their weaknesses, have some of the seven cardinal sins, but sloth was not something which could have tempted Jerzy. He was a man of very hard work, of incessant activity, of great imagination. I valued him for his vision, for his dreams, which he could attract others to it, even though it sometimes seemed completely unreal, up in the clouds. I remember when Jerzy began to talk about the Elizabethan theater in Gdańsk to rebuild this place, to create a Shakespeare center. I rooted for him. And I was infected, as we all were, by the idea, although we did have a half smile, wondering whether he would succeed. When I knew about the plan and I went to London and saw the Globe Theatre, I began thinking, yes, this is possible. The English made a big foundation, big theatrical center there. And going, roaming around La Mancha in Spain, I went to a place which is just like the interior of our Shakespeare theater, Almagro, in a small town in La Mancha, and there is something which is known as Corral de Comedias, a yard of dramatic arts, and indeed this is a rectangular yard with galleries and a place where the stage is at the shorter side. And when I saw the interior of our Shakespeare theater, I could see that this is a vision, the original feature of European theater, except for ancient times.
And I knew that Wielki Teatr Świata. I przypomniałem sobie z moich studiów, z moich poszukiwań, że Calderon pisał takie sztuki jak Wielki Teatr Świata i Życie jest snem, na Boże Ciało. To były tak zwane autos, sztuki, które miały służyć podkreśleniu wielkiego chrześcijańskiego święta.
Great Christian festivity and holiday, and it is grand theater of the world, which is also a morality play, to put it most briefly, because we all know it. There is this story about every one of us to whom God gives a role to play. He is the author of the text, the world is the director, and we are there to play our part. And it doesn't matter if you are the king, a soldier, a farmer, or a beggar. At the end of the day, at the feast which wraps it all up when the curtain falls, this is only going to be about how honest you were in this play, how much you took your role to heart, how authentic you were in your role that you were given. I think that Jerzy, in the theater of his life, played the part that is difficult to name in the Dramatis Personae. But however, whatever name we put to it, he did it with passion, with great involvement, engagement, not with sloth or laziness, and not in a way that would be mediocre. I think this is his last will and testament that he left to us, that we need to continue and accept. I also connected to what Jerzy wrote and what he talked about. There are many painterly scenes with the book about seven cardinal sins. We have a lot of references to the Netherlandish painting of the Golden Age. There are a lot of morality plays there. Calvinist people of the Netherlands stopped painting the Virgin, saints, angels and clouds. They started painting Proverbs, and many of them are great moral messages, such as still lives, vanity still lives. And I'm thinking now about Jerzy's life, that it could resemble such a still life, the way the English put it. Quiet,
zobaczcie, jeśli czytaliście Herberta,
calm life. If you read Herbert,
Martwą naturę z wędzidłem, To pewnie doskonale pamiętacie to, jak opisuje tam wielki ruch wyobraźni artystycznej i wielkie zapotrzebowanie ludzi na taki rodzaj sztuki. To jest opowieść o przedmiotach, które nas otaczają.
It is the story.
To jest tęsknota za tym, żeby trwać tak jak te przedmioty, bo życie ludzkie,
about us longing to continue,
continue
like those objects, because like Rilke said, our life is only
trwają.
For a moment, and we long for continuity,
świeczka,
and yet objects
jeszcze się
you continue.
Pali, a druga
there
na przykład
is a candle that is still lit, and then another one that is already put out. There's just some smoke
at
the
wick,
and there is the lemon that is peeled, and the lemon peel in a spiral. It's a spiral of time, and sometimes there is a clock or a musical instrument that perhaps is still resounding a little bit, just like whatever we leave behind in art.
Tylko martwą skorupą.
But an instrument is only an empty, a dead
jest
shell.
Na przykład kielich, który napełniony jest tylko do połowy, tak
chalice
jak w tej słynnej
that is only half
maturze z
wędzidłem.
I to jest opowieść
z kolei
o umiarkowaniu, o możliwości czynienia tego, co chcę, a nie co mi się chce.
Wanting, doing what I want. Not what I feel like doing, it's just half full, and this is a measure that we need to use to measure life. And if we look at the message behind those still lives, these
images
that are a huge morality play, so there is
carpe
diem on the one hand, it's all beautiful, God-given, created by humans with the hands of artists and artisans. It is a joy to our eyes, like flowers that have been cut and will wither in a moment, and there's work on them already, but let's live this life as best we can, as wisest we can, and let's remember that it's a limited time offer. It's a vanity still life, vanitas vanitatis. That's what the Book of Colette says. So there is this range between wonder or the beauty of creation and the awareness that it is all fleeting. It should construct our life and our perception of the world the way we direct the play of our life.
Zobaczcie, Jerzy, tak mi się skojarzyło z naszym kościołem świętego Jana.
Like when I look at the St. John's Church, where we held Shakespeare Festival at the beginning early on, when we didn't have the theater,
there was
this Last Supper premiere, the big painting, and by Professor Maciej Świerzewski, the painting stood there at the back, and it was as wide as the nave, and we were sitting there, 12 of us, not counting Jesus. I was sitting there as well.
And I stood up and
if someone asked who Judas was, I said maybe me, because I stood up first. And 12 people of Gdańsk, actors, writers, 12 people from the region of Pomerania. And Jerzy was the first one who left from the picture. He is the apostle who is no longer with us, and he will stay in the painting, but he is the first one to have gone to eternity. Let us try to think about it not in terms of a disaster, not in despair, but with hope, like in the first reading, like in the reading from the Book of Wisdom, which says that it was only apparent to the eyes of the unwise that they were dead. Jerzy lives on, like in the vision of revelation of the ultimate future. Everything that is old
has passed,
but now everything becomes new, and we are about to see things that neither the eye has seen nor the ear has heard, what God has prepared for us. And in this grand theater of the world, when the curtain falls right here, right now, we move on backstage, where perhaps life really does begin. Farewell, Jerzy. See you behind the curtain.
Powstańmy teraz i złóżmy przed Bogiem nasze nadzieje, modlitwy.
And let's put our hopes and prayers to the Lord
Kościoła.
In the prayer of the faithful.
Módlmy się o świat bez barier.
Let's pray for a world with no barriers, especially those non-material barriers, so that we are not indifferent to another human being, so that we can live without hate, in mutual respect and in sense of community. Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray that the fight with the pandemic is effective and that our joint effort is able to stop the virus and conclude this time that is difficult to all of us. Let us pray for people of culture, science and art, so that they guard our language, memory and freedom for as long as the world exists in our speech and in our customs. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the late Jerzy Limon, so that he, after the hardships of earthly life, he can participate in the eternal concert of heavenly harps. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for the family and the close ones of the late Jerzy Limon, so that they can get inspired with his example and have the strength to fulfill their dreams. We pray to the Lord. Let us pray for ourselves, so that we do remember that after death our life does change but does not end.
Ciebie prosimy.
We pray to the Lord.
Wysłuchaj nas, dobry Boże, tchnij w nas nadzieję i prowadź nas żyjących drogami Twojej mądrości.
On the roads of your wisdom.
Przez Chrystusa Pana naszego.
Through Christ our Lord.
Spocznijmy.
Let us sit down. Will perform Gudis Maria Mater Gracia.
Módlcie się, bracia I siostry, aby moją I waszą ofiarę przyjął Bóg Ojciec Wszechmogący.
Brothers and sisters, that God Almighty receives our offering. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord.
Wszechmogący Boże, pokornie składamy Ci ofiarę za
As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Jerzy, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing to the hymn of your glory, as without end we claim. Now, the Sanctus.
Zaprawdę święty jesteś, Boże, źródło wszelkiej świętości.
Now the transubstantiation and elevation.
Mocą Twojego Ducha, aby stały się dla nas ciałem I krwią naszego Pana Jezusa Chrystusa. On to, gdy dobrowolnie wydał się na mękę, wziął chleb I dzięki Tobie składając, łamał I rozdawał swoim uczniom, mówiąc: Bierzcie I jedzcie z tego wszyscy. To jest bowiem ciało moje, które za was będzie wydane. Podobnie po wieczerzy wziął kielich I ponownie dzięki Tobie składając, podał swoim uczniom, mówiąc: Bierzcie I pijcie z niego wszyscy. To jest bowiem kielich krwi mojej, nowego I wiecznego przymierza, która za was I za wielu będzie wylana na odpuszczenie grzechów. To czyńcie na moją pamiątkę. Oto wielka tajemnica wiary. Głosimy śmierć Twoją, Panie Jezu. Wyznajemy Twoje zmartwychwstanie I oczekujemy Twego przyjścia w chwale. Wspominając śmierć I zmartwychwstanie Twojego Syna, ofiarujemy Tobie, Boże, chleb życia I kielich zbawienia I dziękujemy, że nas wybrałeś, abyśmy stali przed Tobą I Tobie służyli. Pokornie błagamy, aby Duch Święty zjednoczył nas wszystkich, przyjmujących ciało I krew Chrystusa.
Pamiętaj, Boże, o Twoim Kościele na całej ziemi, Spraw, by lud Twój wzrastał w miłości.
Remember, Lord, your church.
Razem z naszym papieżem Franciszkiem,
together with our Pope Francis, our Bishop Tadeusz, and all the clergy.
Pamiętaj o Twoim słudze Jerzy.
Remember your servant Jerzy, who you have called from this world to your own. Make that he who through baptism has a share in the death of your son has also a share in his resurrection. Remember also about our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep with the hope for resurrection, and all those who have left this world, let them see your light. Have mercy on us all, and give us a share in eternal life with Mary, with Saint Joseph, the saints and apostles,
którzy w ciągu wieków podobali się Tobie, abyśmy z nimi wychwalali Ciebie.
You light for the century so that we may speak your glory through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Przez Chrystusa, z Chrystusem i w Chrystusie, Tobie, Boże Ojcze Wszechmogący, w jedności Ducha Świętego wszelka cześć i chwała przez wszystkie wieki wieku. Amen. Pouczeni przez Zbawiciela i posłuszni Jego słowom, ośmielamy się mówić.
The Lord's Prayer.
Ojcze nasz, któryś jest w niebie, święć się imię Twoje, przyjdź królestwo Twoje, bądź wola Twoja, jako w niebie, tak i na ziemi. Chleba naszego powszedniego daj nam nasze winy, jako i my odpuszczamy naszym winowajcom. I nie wódź nas na pokuszenie, ale nas zbaw ode złego.
Wybaw nas, Panie, od zła wszelkiego i obdarz nasze czasy pokojem. Wspomóż nas w swoim miłosierdziu, abyśmy zawsze wolni od grzechu i bezpieczni od wszelkiego zamętu, pełni nadziei, oczekiwali przyjścia naszego Zbawiciela, Jezusa Chrystusa. Twoje jest. Panie Jezu Chryste, przez Twoją śmierć na krzyżu, Bóg
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace and unity of our kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Peace be with you. Through nodding and smiling, let us give each other the sign of peace. Agnus Dei.
Oto Baranek Boży, który gładzi grzechy świata. Szczęśliwi, którzy mogą przyjąć Go do siebie.
Panie, nie jestem godzien, abyś przyszedł do mnie, ale powiedz tylko słowo, a będzie uzdrowiona dusza moja. Tych, którzy chcą przystąpić do Komunii Świętej, prosimy o
those who want to take the communion, please go to the altar through the middle nave, and we take the Holy Communion onto our outstretched hands. For the communion, Capella Gadenensis and its soloist Magdalena Gruszczyńska perform Gabriel Fauré's Requiem in D minor, Pie Jesu. Módlmy się. Let us pray.
Panie Boże, Twój Lord Syn God, zostawił nam w najświętszym whose Son left us in the sacrament of His body food for the journey,
mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Jerzy may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Dearly beloved, the first act of our farewell is at an end. The liturgical, the Eucharist, is closed with a blessing, but that's not all. Act two will begin in a moment. The farewells from his friends, a song which was composed for Jerzy. The memories we will see on the screen, and our memory of him enclosed in our words and gestures. And Act 3 will be at the cemetery in Sopot at 1400 hours. Thank you for our joint prayer. And now there will be music by Capella Gadenensis. And afterwards we will listen to the speeches
Niech was błogosławi I strzeże.
Lord be with you and you.
Miłosierny Bóg, Ojciec
May
I Syn I Duch
the Lord keep you. The Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. And now, Kapela Gnanensis plays Jesu, Joy of Man's Desiring from Cantata BWV 147 by Johann Sebastian Bach.
Droga Pani Justyno, droga rodzino, szanowni Państwo. Kilka dni temu na ręce Pani Justyny Limon przekazałem list kondolencyjny wraz z bukietem kwiatów na prośbę Jego Królewskiej Wysokości księcia Walii Karola. Odczytam teraz treść tego listu przetłumaczoną na język polski. 12 marca 2021 roku. Szanowna Pani Limon, piszę do Pani przede wszystkim po to, by wyrazić, jak niewypowiedzianie przykra jest dla mnie tragiczna wiadomość o niespodziewanym odejściu Pani męża. Pragnę również złożyć na Pani ręce najszczersze wyrazy współczucia. To okrutne, że Jerzego odebrał nam ten potworny wirus. Trudno mi nawet wyobrazić sobie, jak ogromną wyrwę ta strata powoduje w życiu Pani i Pani rodziny. Mam niezwykle miłe wspomnienia związane z Pani mężem, jeszcze z czasów, gdy po raz pierwszy w 1991 roku poprosił mnie o objęcie patronatu nad Gdańskim Teatrem Szekspirowskim. Był człowiekiem wyjątkowym, którego ciężka praca, wytrwałość i oddanie sztuce, a Szekspirowi w szczególności, były niezrównane. Jerzy zrobił tak wiele, by coraz większe rzesze odbiorców mogły docenić kunszt bodaj najznamienitszego dramatopisarza wszechczasów. Niebywale inspirujące zaangażowanie w projekt Gdańskiego Teatru Szekspirowskiego, który szczerze podziwiam, a którego otwarcie w 2014 roku sprawiło mi ogromną radość, wyróżnia profesora Limona pośród prawdziwych piewców Szekspira i będzie trwałym hołdem dla pamięci Jerzego. Wiem, jak bardzo ceniony był przez wszystkich, którzy z nim pracowali, jak bardzo dotkliwa będzie jego strata dla wielu osób w Polsce, Wielkiej Brytanii i na świecie. Mnie samemu będzie go bardzo brakowało i z całego serca łączę się z panią w bólu. Choć zdaję sobie sprawę, że ten list nie przyniesie pani ulgi, ani nie sprawi, że ta strata będzie łatwiejsza do zniesienia, tak bardzo chciałbym zapewnić panią i pani rodzinę, że są państwo stale obecni w moich myślach i modlitwach w tym potwornie trudnym czasie. Jego Królewska Wysokość Książę Walii Karol. Pani Justyno, proszę również w moim imieniu
also on my behalf, please accept words of support and comfort to you and your whole family. Thank you for your attention.
Szanowna rodzino świętej pamięci Jerzego Limona,
dear
szanowni family państwo,
of the late Jerzy Limon, dear
uderzcie w dzwony, dmi,
ring the alarm bell, blow grzej, wind, toni. Come rack.
Skoro umierać
at
mam,
least we'll die
to z mieczem w dłoni.
With harness on our back.
Macbeth.
Macbeth.
Przedwczesna, niespodziewana untimely, śmierć zatrzymała profesora Jerzego Limona w pełnym biegu aktywności, planów, zamierzeń i wstrząsnęła światem kultury.
And shook the world
odszedł
of culture,
humanista,
an outstanding humanist with a big heart, kindness,
ducha,
cheerfulness,
życie
whose life was the embodiment of universal ideas, has passed away.
Świętej pamięci Jerzy Limon, while receiving one of his numerous awards, said,
theater is not only about history, not only about a space to stage plays, it is also a treasure trove of language and memory.
Marzenie o teatrze z dużej litery zainspirowało go do śmiałych działań, czyniąc autorytetem i międzynarodowym ekspertem. Był niedoścignionym znawcą, miłośnikiem i popularyzatorem twórczości Williama Szekspira. W dziejach kultury współczesnej Jerzy Limon zapisał się jako znakomity anglista, tłumacz, historyk, literaturoznawca i teatrolog. Uczucia smutku i żalu w chwili pożegnania dotykają wszystkich, którym mówi się, a także niezliczone rzeczy
affect all those he was close to, as well as multitudes of those who participated in and witnessed his many accomplishments. They all began with a passion for art and a love of the works of the great Stratfordian to whom he devoted his life's work. As a professor of the humanities, he lectured at the University of Gdańsk. He wrote many books, articles and reviews published both in Poland and around the world. He wrote over 100 entries for the Polish Universal Encyclopedia. He was a member of the Polish Writers Association, the Polish Association of Authors and Composers, Polish Academy of Sciences and the Council for Art, institutions operating at the Ministry of Culture, National Heritage and Sport. Jerzy Limon was a visionary whose thoughts, drawing inspiration from the past, looked far into the future. He established the Theatrum Gedanense Foundation, operating owing to his efforts under the patronage of the Prince of Wales, as well as the Shakespeare Theatre, which he gave an international artistic dimension with his driving energy. His aspirations created a project to build an Elizabethan theatre in Gdańsk. He believed in the idea, but knew after Shakespeare that the flighty purpose never is overtook unless the deed go with it. Therefore, step by step, he consistently blazed the trail from office to office. With his determination and professionalism, he gained the support and the favor of the greatest of skeptics. Since 2014, built upon the dream of Jerzy Limon, the Gdańsk Shakespeare Theater has taken shape and become the pride of the city. The institution he managed has gained international reach, and today gathers artists from all over the world, being at the same time an important center of education. Jerzy Limon proved that it is worth following your heart. He was a gifted and respected man who followed the Platonic ideas of good and beauty. His achievements have received accolades, including the Knight's Cross of the Order of Polonia Restituta, Silver Gloria Artis Medal for Merit to Culture, Officer of the Honorary Order of the British Empire bestowed by Queen Elizabeth II, St. Adalbert's Medal. We commiserate with the family of the deceased using the Master's words once again. Who alone suffers, suffers most in the mind, leaving free things and happy shows behind, but then the mind much sufferance doth or skip when grief hath mates and bearing fellowships. The passing of Jerzy Limon closes an important chapter in Polish culture, but the life he has left behind will be a treasure trove of memory for future generations. Honor to his memory, signed by the Deputy Prime Minister, Deputy Minister of Culture and National Heritage and Sport, Piotr Gliński. When at 1980s I studied at the Philology and History Department at University of Gdańsk, where a young scholar at the time, Jerzy Limon, worked, I realized that there was a person like that who first of all discovered and popularized the knowledge of the presence of theater companies in Gdańsk in the Middle Ages and Renaissance, and he decided to do something about it, to institutionalize it, and that's when the idea to build an Elizabethan theater was born. Then, in the 1980s, we thought it was a crazy idea, a dream never to be realized. We had different problems. You remember what happened in Poland in the 1980s. Whoever would get interested in it, who would give money for it? When free, independent Poland began, Professor Jerzy Limon began very consistently to make this plan happen, and he understood that with private sponsoring, just with private sponsoring, it would not be possible. So he always tried to receive public patronage, state's patronage. So it's not just from the state, but from local government as well. And he succeeded. I remember 2008, when we put the cornerstone in the ground for the Shakespeare Theatre. I thought it was one of the happiest days of Professor Jerzy Limon, who organized this classical ceremony, cornerstone ceremony, but also gave us, the people of Gdańsk, on the steps of the Long Market in Gdańsk, he gave us Shakespeare, performed by the greatest, most outstanding Polish actors. There was a lot of Shakespeare's words in Gdańsk at the time, and it gained great interest. Professor Jerzy Limon understood that you have to build an institution, that campaigns such as an annual Shakespeare festival is not enough. There has to be an institution that works on a daily basis and has staff who take care of this heritage on a daily basis of classical theater, the classical Shakespeare Theatre. And owing to Professor Jerzy Limon, we have such an institution, and it will make Gdańsk famous, keep making it famous for centuries to come. Dear Professor, Gdańsk is grateful to you. Poland is grateful to you. Europe is grateful to you. Rest in peace.
Jak cię żegnać, panie profesorze?
How shall we say goodbye, professor?
Co powiedzieć, gdy
What can we say when a virus,
o ironio, w
how ironic,
w głowie,
with a crown on its head, an attribute of so many of Shakespeare's heroes, takes away our city's dear and cherished citizens?
Rząd siódmy,
Row 7, seats 7 and 8, your seats, are unbearably empty. It's one of those moments when one would rather remain silent because every word spoken in past tense seems to take us to what was, but is no longer. He was an expert on Shakespeare, a teacher, a visionary, the originator of Gdańsk's Shakespeare Festival, and the creator of the Gdańsk Shakespeare Theater was. What's past is prologue, wrote William Shakespeare in The Tempest towards the end of his career, a play with a title that is so fitting for the times of a pandemic. What's past is prologue. In 1790, Princess Isabella Czartoryska brought with her a chair from her trip to England, not just any chair. In the town of Stratford, she went to the house of a woman who claimed she was Shakespeare's descendant. There, she found a piece of furniture that was said to be the bard's favorite for both work and repose. Visitors would pay a pretty penny for the smallest splinter chiseled off the chair to then set it in rings and medallions. Sitting on this chair, attested the princess, I saw before me Juliet and Romeo, Miranda, Desdemona, Hamlet, and Ophelia. To be honest, the chair in the Czartoryski Museum collection does not look as if it is very comfortable. However, that is not the point. The chair is not unlike a reliquary. A small door was put in the back of its backrest, which, when opened, showed its original wooden structure. Dear Director, you have left behind one of the contemporary symbols of our city, the Gdańsk Shakespeare Theater. You have left behind many comfortable chairs and almost as many seats for those who truly love the theater. You have left behind a retractable roof with a view of the heavens. You have left behind festival productions on warm summer evenings and the tradition of staging plays on the theater's walls. Thousands of memories, thrills, and unfinished conversations. Thank you 100-fold. Your past is our prologue, Professor. We want to treat your legacy with no less respect than that which Princess Czartoryska had for William Shakespeare's chair. Yes, Shakespeare can always feel at home in Gdańsk. Good night, and flights of angels sing thee to thy rest.
Kochany profesorze,
dear professor,
drogi Jurku,
dear Jurek,
przyjacielu,
dear friend,
od dnia, w którym
since the day
zostaliśmy
we were so shocked by your sudden and unexpected departure,
nadchodzą z całego świata
reminiscences,
wspomnienia,
poems and wonderful essays
i wspaniałe eseje o tobie.
About you have been coming from all over the
nikt
world.
Nie może pogodzić
nobody
się z
can
tym,
come to terms with the fact that one of the most eminent European intellectuals has passed away in full creative power.
Od początku
From the beginning of the 1990s, the professor created an atmosphere conducive to establishing a Shakespearean theater in Gdańsk, in the historic place where English actors performed in the 17th century. He established the foundation and, over the years, kept building the soul of the future theater. He charmed many lawmakers, local government officials, and business people with his wonderful naivete that allowed him to imagine the most fantastic visions. He persuaded both Prince Charles and Andrzej Wajda, who supported him and were patrons of the undertaking. He needed a new building to create the magic of the theater. He needed modern technology in a historical place to show that everything has changed, but the theater is as it was in Shakespeare's time. He secured European funding to build it based on a remarkable design by an Italian architect and realized his life's work, the magnificent Gdańsk Shakespeare Theater. While giving tours of his theater, he always did it with such passion that you had the impression that he was doing it for the first time and that he himself was discovering something and was delighted with it. In one of his many books, Between the Sky and the Stage, he wrote about theater as an almost magical space in which signs of the fictional world are created. He ran the theater with a small team of associates whom he admired, loved, and treated as family. Now, time has stopped for them, and no words can convey the emptiness they have in their hearts. He attracted what's best to Gdańsk. He was like a magnet. He created an institution of European culture in Gdańsk, promoting Gdańsk as an open and multicultural city. He did not like cliches, artificiality, or pomposity. He was extremely modest and sensitive. Therefore, when he received accolades, he was always very touched or even confused. This was the case at Babel Castle, where he was awarded the Polish Nobel Prize, at the Royal Castle, where he received the Professor Geistor Award, or in Stratford, where he was counted among the greatest experts in English literature and brilliant researchers of Shakespeare's works ever. Not only an outstanding and extraordinary professor left us, but also an exceptionally good and kind person, loved by family and adored by friends, a subtle, well-mannered interlocutor, full of charm, who invited actors, painters, writers, sculptors, and theater lovers to his home for dinner that he made himself. It is our duty to care for the memory and legacy of this modern hero.
I za każdym razem,
and every time
kiedy będziemy
we are
w jego teatrze,
at his theater,
i po spektaklu,
and after the performance,
otworzy się
when his beloved retractable roof opens up to
ukochany,
the moon and stars,
otwierany dach, podpiszmy
let us sign this piece of heaven seen from inside
teatru,
the theater
teatralnym
as Jerzy Limon's theatrical
Limona.
Heaven.
To w końcu
after
jego
all,
niebo,
it is his heaven
liczyć,
that he can count on.
Żegnaj, kochany
przyjaciel. Farewell, my dearest friend. Farewell, Jurek.
Droga Justyno,
dear Justyno,
Julia Tomku,
Julia Tomek,
bliscy przyjaciele,
friends,
drogi Jerzy,
dear Jerzy,
poznaliśmy się 40
we
lat
met
temu,
40 years ago,
w zupełnie innej epoce,
in a completely
I my
different
też
era,
byliśmy
and
inni.
We were
jeszcze
different
młodzi,
too, young,
w pełni pomysłów
but already
na
full
życie,
of ideas for
czasach.
Our own lives in those difficult times. Your idea was to return to Gdańsk from Poznań, but also from America, England, Berlin, from the 16th century and the English of its time. You were at ease with various eras and various continents. You would be in royal courts and in smoky artistic clubs and pubs. You were an intellectual who went outside the framework of the academia. I am still grateful to fate and your brother Janusz for our meeting which played a part in my further 40 years. We spent a lot of those 40 years together working on things, all of it under our friendship. You were and will always be a very important person to me. I hope you knew that. But you weren't just important to me. Your many talents, incredible knowledge, your being full of ideas, your consistency and tenaciousness, all these incredible features which have been mentioned today so much were gifts which you gave to us all, your family, friends, students and artists. It's as if it was Shakespeare Ulysses who said about you, regardless of what a man has, he will not be able to boast of anyone, won't know what he has if the reflection of his riches are not found in others, because only the shine of virtue will be repaid by the warmth of gratitude, and no one shall become great if he does not serve any with his strength. We honor your deeds. We thank you for your gifts, for your books, for your lectures, for inspiring conversations, for your festivals, for Shakespeare, but most of all, by your monumental gift to Gdańsk and Pomerania, for the Gdańsk Shakespeare Theater. Happy is the one who takes so many disciples after him, because we're following you and everyone here. Everyone here are your disciples, presidents, marshals, ministers, artists, professors. We promise to take your work upon ourselves and further it. The first to say farewell was the Prince of Wales, the patron of the Shakespeare Theater. But you are a prince in your theater as well, Jerzy. Because, so as an aristocrat of the soul, let me say farewell with the words of Shakespeare's chorus. The heart is broken. Good night, my prince. Sweet prince.
Jurku, mój kochany. Jurek, my dearest, you left suddenly with no farewell. It is such a sudden Shakespearean tempest that took you away, but not forever. You are alive in us because you said yourself that memory creates us. We are our memory. It will continue, like in your favorite metaphor in Shakespeare, until the last syllable of time. I am grateful to Providence that it allowed me to meet you for our 40 years of love and happiness, for our beautiful life. I don't want to say goodbye. I want to believe that you are always going to be with me, with us. You often wrote about memory and history. Today, I would like to quote a certain story from your life when you were a young 18-year-old man after your graduation exam before the university. You were an acoustician, a sound engineer, with going on tours with the big beat bands. That's when you became friends with Tadeusz. And Tadeusz, a friend from those years, Tadeusz Metzeldowski, composed and recorded and sang for you a song which so much resembles those years. And it reminds us of you, this young dreamer whom muses and fortune always were favorable to honor Jurek. This song is called Teatrum Gadanense. It will be sung by Tadeusz Metzveldowski.
Wszystkie twoje pasje i na życie plany. Z takich pasji właśnie teatr zbudowany. Teatr twój ogromny w sercu tego miasta będzie dla potomnych świecił niczym gwiazda. Teraz pewnie wiesz, tę drogę już znasz, żeby tak znieść Teatrum Gadanense. Taki życia sens. profesorze nas. Teatrum Gedanense. Teatrum Gedanense. Dach tobie odsłonię, byś mógł patrzeć na to, jak teatr w pokłonie tobie bije brawo. Nim opadnie kurtyna, światła rampy zgasną, sonety Szekspira do nieba popłyną. Teraz pewnie wiesz, tę drogę już znasz, żeby tak znieść. Teatrum Gedanense. Taki życia sens. Profesorze nas. Teatrum Gedanense. Teatrum Gedanense. Taki życia sens. Profesorze nas. Teatrum Gedanense. Teatrum Gedanense.
Cały świat to scena.
All the world is a stage.
To tylko aktorzy. Każdy z nich wchodzi na scenę i znika. A kiedy na niej jest, gra różne role w siedmioaktowym dramacie żywota. Najpierw niemowlę śliniące się z wrzaskiem w ramionach niańki. Potem uczniak z torbą na książki, z buzią jak wypucowane poranne niebo, wlokący się z jękiem do nielubianej szkoły. W trzecim akcie kochanek, który żarem westchnień bucha jak piec i składa smętne serenady o brwiach Bogdanki. Jeszcze później żołnierz, z gębą klątw dziwnych pełną i z wąsami nastroszonymi w szpic jak u pantery, skory do bitki z drażliwym honorem, goniący zamydlaną bańką sławy prosto w armatnią gardziel. Potem sędzia z brzuchem tuczonym kapłonami, które znoszą mu w darze podsądni, z surowym okiem i brodą pod sznurek przyciętą, sypiąc cytaty i przykłady z życia, gra swoją rolę. Tak to grając zdążamy do ostatniej mety, i tylko umieramy na serio, niestety.
Nie jestem pewien, czy to, co oglądam, jest realne, czy może snem. I poprosiłem, żeby mnie z tego snu nie budzono, bo chciałbym, żeby trwał wiecznie. Kiedy 25 lat temu zrodziła się idea budowy Teatru Szekspirowskiego w Gdańsku, wszyscy, łącznie z moją rodziną, uważali, że oszalałem. I ta łatka szaleństwa trochę do mnie się przypięła i towarzyszy mi przez ten cały okres. Ale na pocieszenie zostaje mi sam Szekspir, który szaleństwo wprowadza do kilku sztuk. Najbardziej znane jest szaleństwo Hamleta, który właśnie nie chcąc się poddać konwenansom dworskim, nie chcąc ulegać okowom tradycji, przywdziewa maskę szaleństwa. Nie to, że nie chcę się porównywać, broń Boże, z Hamletem, ani hamletyzować, ale coś w tym jest chyba, że marzenia, sny są z tej samej tkanki, co szał. Przecież starożytni już wprowadzili pojęcie furor divinus, boskiego szału, który towarzyszy wszelkim działaniom twórczym, a twórczością jest również budowa teatru. Towarzyszy wszelkim działaniom twórczym, a twórczością jest również budowa teatru.
Fragment koncertu Wielkiej Niedźwiedzicy.
A fragment of the concert of Ursa Major by Jerzy Limon.
Chłopiec zaczął baczniej przyglądać się światu.
The boy began to observe the world more closely and he noticed that in the end everything dies. He saw, for example, that beautiful butterflies which he so admired and which he chased over the waterlogged meadows beyond the village lived only for one summer and then died. So he began to worry increasingly often that his life would be the same, and even if he lived for more years, he would still die in the end. And he really did not want to die. And the more he thought about it, the more he became convinced that it would be best to live forever. But he did not know how to achieve this, and no adult could offer any sensible suggestions. He did not, however, lose hope, and he went to see the wise old man, the explorer of the skies, who knew everything and could read the stars. Tell me, wise old man, who lives longer, a butterfly or a person? To the boy's surprise, the all-knowing old man gave an evasive answer. It so happens that, from the point of view of a person, a butterfly lives a very short life, while, from the point of view of a butterfly, a person lives for a very long time. But in reality, both live equally long. But what can I do to live forever? The boy persisted. Nothing lives forever, replied the old man. Even the hardest rock will be crushed by time. Is that true? That nothing lives forever? Well, maybe just the stars, the old man answered. So, how can I become a star? The boy went on. You would have to sacrifice your life for someone, said the old man. After which he returned to his interrupted meditation, letting the boy know that he had no desire to continue the conversation. The boy looked at the night sky, at Ursa Major curved in the firmament suspended above the summit of the rock, and slowly began to understand the words of the wise old man, that only the light of the stars is eternal. It seemed to him that Ursa Major was playing on some great heavenly instrument, on the wings of the galactic wind, and before the nightly concert of the spheres, immersed in the music of the stars, she tunes her heavenly instrument, that mysterious harp, whose strings are touched by the breath of angels, and in whose chords there comes to life a delightful, albeit almost unheard by most, harmony illuminated by the pole star and the billowy wind clouds of the Milky Way.
Thank you.